Hachette Audio presents Work Happy, What Great Bosses Know. Written by Jill Geisler. Read by Rhoda Griffin.
For Neil, Noah, and Mac, the soul of the real me, who make work and life happy. Introduction. This audiobook makes a bold promise. It will help grow great bosses and happy workplaces. Chapter by chapter, we'll take a professional and personal journey together. Because you are trusting me to be your guide, you deserve to know how I've come to be a leadership teacher and coach for countless managers. It's a story that begins years ago with three little words. Are you crazy? That was the warm response from the corporate brass when my boss promoted me to management. The home office couldn't fathom it. Why would the head of a major market TV station hand its newsroom keys to an untested 27-year-old reporter whose only prior management experience was a high school summer job in a candy store? This was high-stakes supervision. There was a multi-million dollar budget to manage, legal, ethical, and regulatory issues to master, competitive strategy in media and marketing to devise, technology to deploy, unions to work with, contracts to negotiate, daily newscasts to oversee, and the small matter of the care and feeding of a staff of 50, some of whose egos ranged in size from large to extra large. Oh, and the year was 1978. Women news directors were a rarity back then. You can check the broadcast history books, or just watch Mary Tyler Moore Show reruns for proof. Maybe my boss was crazy, but where corporate saw insanity, he saw possibility. He took a risk. Each day, someone with power invests it in someone else, transforming the chosen person from staff to management, from producer to supervisor, and in the best cases, from follower to leader, all with the simple change of a title. It's always a risk. Most managers plunge in without benefit of training. It's a story that might sound familiar to you as a manager, or one you might face in the future if management is your goal. It goes like this. You're a good performer, so you are tapped to lead a team, and then everything changes. What made you good at your craft isn't guaranteed to make you good at helping others excel. Even if you are smart, dedicated, and have a stellar work ethic, you have gaps in your supervisory skills, maybe some big ones. You make mistakes that can hurt employees, your company, and your own career. Like me, you can learn and even teach from those mistakes. You may get some limited training depending on your organization. You might find mentors to guide you. You might invest in some books. But which books? The store shelves are full of them, and you have precious little free time. You want and deserve one good book that brings together the most relevant and reliable advice for managers or aspiring managers at all stages of their careers. As someone who strives to be a great boss, you want to master the things the great ones do and learn the secrets they know. I promise to tell you. So how do I know what makes work happy and what great bosses know? For the answer, I must take you back to my personal and professional adventure in leadership and the surprising outcome. My boss's crazy big risk apparently paid off. I may have been too young, too inexperienced, and definitely not man enough to fit the traditional profile of 70s broadcast news director, but things actually worked out quite well. In a hard, competitive business where the average shelf life of a news director is 2 years, I ended up leading my team for more than 2 decades. Yes, 20-plus years leading a team, building a culture and systems and growing a talented staff, some of whom set down roots, and others who are doing distinguished work across the country today. On top of that, our station went through 5 changes of ownership during my tenure. Each new set of overseers would conduct their due diligence, survey our performance, and choose to keep our management team intact. On every important score, revenue, ratings, award-winning quality, innovation, integrity, and employee engagement, we delivered. That success came to the attention of the Poynter Institute, a highly respected nonprofit school in St. Petersburg, Florida. It specializes in sharing best practices through programs that are innovative, interactive, and engaging. Starting in the early 90s, I was invited to serve as occasional guest faculty for the Institute's management seminars. It was there that I began to frame and give form to the management ideas and techniques I'd adopted or abandoned. I shared my successes and failures in ways that helped other supervisors improve their performance. And we laughed a lot. I consider that a vital part of teaching, learning, and leading. It also explains why this audiobook is titled Work Happy. I must have done something right. In 1998, Poynter invited me to leave my newsroom, which by then had grown to about 100 employees, and joined the Institute's small and special faculty. While I had absolutely loved being a vice president of news in a demanding industry, my heart told me it was time for a new challenge. Helping managers has been my life and passion ever since. I teach and coach leaders around the world, write advice columns for bosses in all professions, and produce What Great Bosses Know podcasts that have had millions of downloads on iTunes, U, and led to this audiobook. Along the way, I earned a master's degree in leadership studies and continuously devoured business management literature, especially information that is research-based. Frankly, there's an abundance of untested opinions and frothy folktales about leadership out there. My training as a journalist makes me extremely picky about citing authoritative sources. That's part of how I know what great bosses know. But there's more. I have a priceless pipeline of information about the best and worst behaviors of bosses and insights into happy workplaces. Let me explain. When I took responsibility for our Institute's leadership and management programs, I introduced a new element to our teaching, something that improved our effectiveness and, according to the participants, became the most valuable part of their management learning experience. I developed our own version of what social scientists call a multi-rater feedback instrument, commonly known as 360-degree feedback. The managers I teach solicit feedback from their bosses, from fellow managers, and from employees. I have read thousands, yes, thousands of these reports, taking in detailed descriptions of what the best bosses know and do. The feedback also speaks candidly about what bosses need to do better. I've selected some powerful statements from those feedback reports to share with you in this audiobook, because they represent the voices of real people talking about real bosses. Don't expect to read the names of folks who sent or received this feedback. I care deeply about the managers I teach, and neither generous bribes nor enhanced interrogation methods would persuade me to violate their privacy. This audiobook is about great bosses, not great gossip. In some cases, I've done very light editing of the feedback for clarity, brevity, and grammar, or to substitute the word manager or boss for a person's specific title or name, but never to alter the meaning or impact of the praise or criticism. There is one name I'll share openly when reporting on managerial missteps, my own. As I like to tell managers, I teach from my mistakes, so you won't make them too. So, let's get started. With the focus on you and what the people you work with would say if they were asked to evaluate your skills as a boss. Here's our goal. Whatever they say today will pale in comparison to the praise you'll hear in the very near future, after you've graduated from the lessons in this audiobook, and see how the words work and happy can flourish side by side. Let the fun begin. Section 1. All About You. How Bosses Become Great. Chapter 1. The Challenges and Joys of Management. A Reality Check. Imagine this. I've just handed you a manila folder. You are nervous. You've never looked at feedback like this before. It's a report card, but without numeric or letter grades. Instead, it is page upon page of candid comments about your strengths and weaknesses as a manager, written by those who interact.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.